Good day, everybody. Today we are going to review this Tucson 2018 pre-facelift model. This is the third generation Tucson. Okay, this will be the Tucson front end. This is on the right driving side. This tool projector lamp is LED. Turning signal lamp is inside there. This is the highlight. This is when you on the daylight. The main light is on, then the daylight will be here. This will be the fog lamp. This is the normal daylight. So this is the front end of the car. This will be the turn lamp for driver side, and another side will be the same. I'm showing you one part of it only. This will beam on the side. This is how it looks like during normal. This is the daylight on, normal mode. So you turn on the headlamp, the main headlamp. These two sides, we have the daylight will come on top of the main light. Fog lamp are traditional bulb type. Signal lamp, bulb, main light, the highlight bulb, LED on main light. Fog lamp, bulb, LED. One front sensor, second sensor, third sensor, and the fourth sensor. Front got four sensors. This is the front camera location on top of the number plate.
Near to the car, the turn below the side mirror, you will see a welcoming light below the side mirror.
To the door, they will have a welcoming light on the door handle here as well, but you still need to press this button to unlock. This is how the welcoming light looks like for both sides.
This car engine is powered by a 1.6 liter turbo dual VVT-i direct injection engine. Maximum power delivery for 175 horses at 5,500 RPM. And 265 newton meter of torque during 1500 RPM towards 5500 RPM. This car engine is mated to a dual clutch 7-speed transmission.
As for the front, this is also almost the same at the back. Leather wrapping, a soft leather wrapping here. Other than that, all are hard plastic. This is a speaker grill, the tilter grill, mostly are hard. The pocket from the front door is quite big compared to the back. And this door do have the automatic door windows control. This is the unlock button, window lock, mirror control, side mirror folding is all at the driver's side. Driver seat, you do have a powered adjustment power seat. So this, even though it's not started the car, you can see the driving side, you can adjust it. This is the brightness control for your main instrument cluster after you on your this headlamp. This is the front camera. This camera will be displayed on your main media player here, but during low speed and parking time, after 10 km per hour, the display will be turned off. This is your traction control. This is your boot, auto boot opener. When you on your front camera display on the media player here, your radio is not playing, it only display the front camera only. All media is been disabled. So this is on the, this is a steering wheel. On the left is a media player, on the right is the car information display thing. You have cruise control here, set and okay button. This paper thing here is to select the option inside the car display, main display. The up down arrow is for the up down arrow to choose what you want, and the OK button is also click on what you want to select on it. So basically you have the main display here. This is the tank, fuel tank to empty. Below is the per liter, km per liter. I set to km per liter, meaning 1 liter I can go how far. You can also set how many liter per 100 km. This is trip A, and the hour has been drive in this petrol, this tank of petrol. This trip B is, I didn't say anything, I just leave it here lah, because I didn't use it. And then you see the speedometer here. On the left hand side is a media thing, so it's nothing fancy also. Mute the radio, select media selective, volume up down, channel up down or selection, call or hang up your phone. Okay, let's talk about this media head unit, meaning the main head unit lah. So you have power button, press is power button, and then turn is volume. Right hand side is adjustment tuning volume lah, or selected volume. selector knob, sorry. So it's an Android system, as you can see. It has Waze built-in, but my Waze had problem already. I mistaken format the whole head unit, so now I have to ask the people and come in install. Already pre-scheduled with Hyundai area, so I have to do it next week. So normally I'll use this head unit for Google Map and Waze. Waze is mostly for check traffic. Other than that, you have radio, everything is in, Bluetooth, aux in. The aux cable is here, so your aux is sharing the same channel as your front camera. When you turn on it, then the aux cannot be used, meaning everything will be disabled when you on the front camera. This is a simple acknowledgement. There has one GPS card, I do not know what is it, and you can also install your own SD card if you want to, but I'm not going to do it because I have USB thumb drive here. I can play my music as I want. So this is about the head unit. This is the aircon unit. On the left is fan speed, on the right is temperature. And this column here, this is not a digital air conditioner because the newer version will have digital, but the older version don't have. So if you want digital, go for the new model. This one is blue, is cold, red is hot, but surprisingly Malaysia will have this hot compressor. So because in our temperature we don't need hot because every day is hot. This is all the semi-digital function here. This is those aircon, how do you want the blower will be. Below is defroster, the first two. This is circulation and aircon. Nothing fancy. For this gear lever, this is a DSG gear lever. So P, R, N and D, you can see on here, you can see a P, a plus and minus sign. This is for y'all to do menu shifting. Normally I don't do it because the computer is, I think for me, is smart enough to do it, to help me to do, except during jam time at very low speed. Only I'll use this gear. I will explain the gear selecting thing during my another video. My impression of this car. So this one is mainly to have a short review of it only. Okay, you have two cubby hole, one big, one small, and then one square one. You can put rubbish here or whatever you want. This is all the thing. So you have one digit electronic parking handbrake, auto hole. This is tri mode to select from eco, normal or sport mode. This is parking sensor. In front of parking sensor, this is downhill assist button. I find this downhill assist button a bit harsh, because it try to brake very hardly, because I try on a car park area. So we have another test on it, see how was it during the, in the future. This is the main center console area, sorry about the mess. You can put key here, quite big hole. But I think it's enough, but my wife see it's too small for her handbag, so it's true also. Female friend, beware, use smaller handbag please. For the passenger side, everything almost cloned over from the driver's side. Soft touch. This car do come with 6 speaker system, 2 tutor, 4 mid and low speaker. So this is the glove box. It's quite okay, it's big enough for me. With a luminous light, meaning got light there. Other than that, okay, fair. Still not able to fit in handbag. Car does not come with the shoe holder below your seat like Pro Duo Alza or MyV have. So this is typical one. You cannot keep an extra shoes in the car. So this is the second row door. Okay. Okay, small pocket size door handle. This is soft touch. This area is soft touch as well. This is real stitching. This is leather, very thin leather, thin without any spun leather. Door handle, automatic one. Okay, this is the leg room. The seat is leather as well. This is all hard plastic. There's a logo Tucson here. Let's go in. Okay, I am set to my usual driving position. I am 170 cm tall. Okay, I'm 100. Oh, sorry, the angle is not wide enough. Okay, I'm 170 cm tall. This is my sitting position. I set to my driving position. So I'm still got around 10 finger, 12 finger. I'm 170 cm tall. And we have ample space because this seat was sloped out. At the back, we do have an air conditioner unit. And then the floor area is considered 80% flat because we still have a hump here. You can see my hand, there's a hump. Because this car do come with four-wheel drive, but my model doesn't come with. I think Malaysia will not have anymore. All are two-wheel drive model. So this is the back now. I have adjusted this back toner cover to the back so you can see more folded. So after the adjustment, you can see this is the standard. If the toner cover is on the normal position, meaning maximum storage, less of folding the chair down. So now I'm doing less capacity, but I can fold more. You can see my whole body is folded down. So you can able to sleep at the back here. So if you are this, I think this is a normal sedan position or a limit. Okay, this should be the normal sedan position I'm sitting. So if you have a sedan, you should be sitting in this area. Sorry, this angle is not wide enough. So this is a normal sedan position. I think temporary, I know two cars have this function. There is CLV and this. And you can see I'm almost laying down. Consider as laying down. So this is the specialty of this car. You can lay down as this much space. So you can see on here, this is a toner hole here. Origin is here, and now I move it back. So less capacity, more of sleeping position for your middle row, second row passenger. Okay, now we'll measure the width of this area. Behind we have a power socket. Okay, total width is 1.2 something meter. Okay, sorry, I just know the measurement a bit of area. Though the total depth for below is around 84 cm deep. Okay, this is the standard measurement from the top cover lid. So it's around 50 something each cm for the top. So it's not fully squared. Let's have a height check. 0.7 something lah. So this is the total volume capacity. I don't know how to calculate it, but this is the deep, wide, everything lah. So now the back seat, the second row position is on normal, meaning you only use maximum the capacity for cargo. If you want to have more comfort seat, you have to put this cargo lid behind here. So this will reduce your total cargo capacity. You can see, so you have to leave some space for the boot, for the back seat to lean down more. If we close the boot lid cover, I'll show you guys how tall can you keep your things. Okay, let's have a look. They will have 0.4 something height. The wide and the deep are the same, because we only cluster it up just to prevent people from getting to know what you are carrying in, and for safety purposes. So you have to put cover lid on. So we do have a net to prevent your thing from falling around, and I temporarily put it here because I'm not using it, but it's quite troublesome. I just want to prevent from my thing from scratching my back door area. Overall, the boot size is quite okay lah. For me, it's not the biggest compared to CRV, but it's still reasonable size. So this is the back area. This is the back brake light. Everything is normal traditional bulb, as you can see. Left and right are the same. Below we have rear fog lamp. At the bumper there, the rear fog lamp at. This car third brake light is LED. It's using a 17 rim size, so the tire size is 255/60 out 17.
Thank you for viewing this Hyundai Tucson review. I will share my
driving experience and what I like and dislike on this car in a separate video. Thank you for viewing. If you like my video, please click on the subscribe button. Thank you.